The original Power Rangers would have you believe that the most dangerous thing that can happen is a giant monster created by Rita Repulsa. But watch the original show again, that may not be true. The most dangerous thing that Repulsa does may come before she makes any monsters grow, something potentially so dangerous that militaries have considered it a means of mass destruction for the last few decades. It's throwing this thing. And that's it. Remember the original Power Rangers? It was a simpler time, it was a better time. I had the toys, I knew the moves, and I always just assumed that the giant monsters were the true threat. But after receiving this question from Alucian Turan on Twitter, I realized that throwing a staff from the moon to Earth had the potential to be a catastrophe that not even the Megazord could handle. The theory here is that Repulsa's staff might be considered a kinetic impactor, more or less a giant metal tube dropped from orbit. For example, a tungsten rod the size of a telephone pole, if it was in orbit and then directed into Earth's atmosphere, would be traveling by the time it reached the ground 3 kilometers per second, or Mach 10. Ay, ay, ay. And right before impact, all of the impactor's energy would be in the form of kinetic energy equal to 1/2 the mass times velocity squared. This was the critical calculation in the proposed Project Thor in the 1950s, and would drop a tungsten rod the size of a telephone pole through the atmosphere to deliver the equivalent, bound up in kinetic energy, of 12 tons of TNT anywhere on the surface of the Earth in minutes. But a tungsten telephone pole-sized space bullet would weigh many tons and travel through the atmosphere very, very quickly. So to find out if Rita Repulsa's staff is more than just a staff, we have to estimate both its mass and its velocity to see if it has the true power of a kinetic impactor.
If you don't like math, this part of the episode is going to be a bit of a drag, Rangers. You'll get it.
No matter how fast an object is traveling through space, when it encounters Earth's atmosphere, air will get in the way and act to slow it down, even as gravity fights to accelerate it. We can calculate just how much an object will slow down by including drag force inside of a freefall equation, which, given enough distance, will slow an object down to its terminal velocity, or when an object's weight equals the drag force acting on it. This terminal velocity equation has mass, and gravity, and density, and area, and a drag coefficient, so now we need some staff statistics. I'm going to assume a 2.5 centimeter diameter staff that is pointed at one end, and that the staff weighs 5 kilograms. I'm also going to assume that the drag coefficient is 0.2. The drag coefficient is critical in determining how much drag force applies to an object, and this is pretty generous. Now it's time to plug the numbers in. I'm sorry. Given our assumptions and using the acceleration due to gravity on Earth's surface as well as a constant air density for the Earth's atmosphere, we get a terminal velocity for Rita Repulsa's staff of 900 meters per second, almost Mach 3, or 3 times the speed of sound. This, in effect, would have an impact like 1 kilogram of TNT going off, but in kinetic energy. Maybe not enough to destroy the Megazord, but it's still impressive for a staff. Velocity will be the critical component here, so what if Rita's staff did strike the ground like a kinetic impactor? If you change the variables around a bit, like staff area and staff drag coefficient, Rita's staff then, if it was perfectly streamlined, could hit the ground like a scary space weapon traveling beyond Mach 10. And if it did, it would have the kinetic energy of an armor-piercing tank round. Now that would do some damage. So, if Rita Repulsa really did throw her staff to Earth like this, then it would impact the ground with the same amount of energy as an armor-piercing tank round and do a decent amount of damage. I guess it's not the same kind of damage that a giant monster would do, but wait, stop the tape, roll back. How long does it take the staff to get from the moon to Earth? Count it. Yeah, I count about 3 seconds. We gotta go back. This changes everything. Gotta go back. The moon is 384,000 kilometers away. To cross that immense distance in just 3 seconds points to an absurd average staff speed. This would be a velocity a decent fraction of the speed of light, and I have no idea how it would travel this fast or how it would even travel through the atmosphere. Not even meteors can do that, but we see it do just that, and if it did, it would impact the ground with the same kinetic energy to form a crater like Meteor Crater in Arizona, with 40,000 trillion joules of kinetic energy. It's a crater a kilometer wide and 170 meters deep. This would be enough to destroy the Megazord, and is way more dangerous than any giant monster. So, could Rita Repulsa's staff in fact be more dangerous than the monster she creates with it? Well, if it was indestructible and can move through the atmosphere as quickly and as perfectly as we see it do in the show, then it would become a kinetic impactor sent from the moon that would at the very least be deadly for a ranger and at most be able to wipe out an entire city. And because it's a moon base, these orbital strikes could happen anywhere at any time. That is certainly more dangerous than a giant pig monster that can be defeated by feeding it a spicy radish. Why? Because science. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to follow me on Twitter at SciFi, where you can suggest ideas for future episodes like the idea that spawned this episode, and on Instagram under the same handle where I'm now posting mini episodes like the one I did today about Goldar. Go check it out, and thanks for watching. I already said that. Bye. Get ready because it's morphin' time! The Power Rangers will be shifting into turbo and rocketing onto the big screen. Five ordinary teens must become something extraordinary when they learn that their small town of Angel Grove and the world is on the verge of being obliterated by an alien threat. The reimagined Rangers stars a diverse group of up-and-comers including Dacre Montgomery, Naomi Scott, RJ Seiler, Becky G, Ludie Lin, and features veteran badasses Bill Hader, Elizabeth Banks, and Bryan Cranston. Go, go, check out Power Rangers, one of the most highly anticipated films of the year on Friday, March 24th. Go, go. You know that Lord Zed dude? He doesn't have any skin, and he lives on the moon. The moon has no atmosphere. When there's a significant difference in pressure for a liquid usually has what's called a vapor pressure. So there's a liquid, and then there's a tiny amount of liquid over top of it that's in the form of vapor. And that's because it feels, quote unquote, it feels the need to fill vacuums with some of itself. This is why water will boil at lower pressures, because if you lower the pressure on the outside of the water, water wants to evaporate up and fill that vacuum. So, if you had no skin and there was blood all over you all the time, and you were on the moon with no atmosphere, the difference in pressure between your blood, the liquid that is your blood, and the moon's atmosphere would mean that Lord Zed would constantly be surrounded by a vapor of blood gas, because the blood would be compelled to fill the vacuum with some of its own vapor. So not only is he villainous, he would look soups gross.